Hello everyone, I'm Norman Wahlberger, and today we're starting a new series, which is a continuation of sorts to our solving polynomial equations series. But I think that's come to a close in the sense that we have now a relatively coherent story for solving a general polynomial equation in a quite dramatically new way with all kinds of interesting connections to combinatorics. So now I want to write that up. And so I propose to create a series of videos where I talk about the process of writing a mathematics paper. So this should be of interest to graduate students writing their PhD, or young academics, or even just amateurs who are interested in seeing how it goes and what's involved and the orientation that one might have to various things. Now, ideally, you will have gone through a good part of the solving polynomial equations journey so that you have seen what I've been doing. That was a rather relaxed development and investigation, and I wrote up most everything in Scientific Workplace loosely. And now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take bits and pieces of what we've already done and try to package it into a coherent framework. So I have a first draft which I'm going to show you. Okay, so this is a new paper called RSP Equations Paper 1, and it's been obtained by taking the material that we've already done and just basically, cutting and pasting bits and pieces of it and arranging it into some kind of framework. So let me just quickly scroll th through the Scientific Work document so you sort of see how that looks. Okay, so here we are. So there's an introduction, and the introduction I'm trying to outline to somebody who is not going to read the paper necessarily what are the main points of the paper. So this introduction for me is a condensed summary without any proofs of the main definitions and the main results so that somebody can just read the introduction and they get at least a rough idea of what the paper is about and what the main results are. Okay, so there's a self-contained aspect, although it's actually quite concise. So we're introducing various things. We're introducing RSPs, we're introducing these K-area multiproducts. We have some diagrams to illustrate those. We have this important theorem that the number of RSPs with given number of trigons, fourgons, and fivegons is given by our RSP number. Okay. We have connection with algebraic equations, and then we have our sort of basic our two mega formulas. The mega solution of the geometric polynomial equation, which is of this form here, and there's the general solution in terms of these RSP numbers and these certain monomials. And then the mega solution to the general polynomial equation, which is a change of variables from this one. So those are the sort of the main theoretical results. And then I also make a small reference to some numerical solutions. We are interested in numerical solutions, so I will try to say something about how we can actually get approximate solutions using this technology. Okay, so this is as much an aid for me in setting up the paper. So I'm outlining what I want to do in, and identifying what are the main results that I want to be at the heart of the paper. Okay, so now if we look at the sections, so I've got various sections, and the sections already sort of indicate a rough structuring of the paper. So let's just have a look at that only. Just go through the sections. So the first section is the quadratic case. I'm going to talk about the quadratic case. And the next one is the cubic case. So I think the step from quadratic to cubic is really a big one. It's a big one historically, and it's also a key stepping stone to the general case. And they are of independent interest because the cubic equation is notoriously hard. Modern students of mathematics essentially don't know how to solve cubic equations. I mean, that's the reality. So we are presenting actually a viable, ultimately, quite a beautiful solution. So even if you're not interested in the general formula, that's too much. The quadratic and cubic cases are worth enunciating clearly. Okay, I'm going to talk about sub-multinomial coefficients, just what these are, and then the properties of the bitrine numbers. So these are the RSP numbers that occur in the cubic case. And might also talk about the properties of the bitri-quad numbers, just to get people used to the idea that we're extending this Catalan story sort of in multi-dimensional kind of fashion. It's not just a planar story. Then the multiset R of roofed subdivided polygons and their algebra. So that's our sort of fundamental geometrical object, is this multiset of roofed subdivided polygons. That's, for us, the geometrical heart of the matter. And then counting RSP numbers, where we try to, you know, count these RSP numbers and show that they actually are these R numbers, you know, that they're counting RSPs. And then we have our meta formula, first of all, in the geometric form, which is simpler because that's a power series, and then the more general form, which is not quite a power series because there's negative powers of C1. And then we should say something about numerical approximate solutions, although probably there'll be much more to say about that. That's not really the main point, but I do want people to realize that this is not entirely just algebraic, that there's also, you know, actual practical applications of this, although, you know, there might be a lot to investigate in that direction. And I want to at least mention this bootstrapping technology. Okay, so let me just quickly flip through what it actually looks like. So basically, I haven't done too much. I've only spent maybe 2 or 3 hours on this. So I've just taken bits and pieces of the material that we've already done and placed them in here and said a little bit more about some of them. But it's certainly not a coherent story at all yet. But I just want to get the equations there so I can look at them, so I can check them. And then I'm going to tie them together and, of course, prove them and illustrate them and talk about them and explain things further. All right. But this is kind of a great sort of skeletal framework for the entire thing. Okay, so sub-multinomial coefficients, properties of bitrine numbers. I like arrays. I like explicit examples of things. Making contact with the online encyclopedia. We're going to be quite systematic about that. I want to be very clear about what is already in the online encyclopedia and what is new here, because I think there's a lot of new things that are happening. So that'll be quite interesting. And then not just the bitri numbers, but I also want to get a sense of these bitri quad numbers. You may remember I talked a little bit about them. So they're also interesting, sort of intriguing properties of these things as we go up the cross diagonal, which we don't quite understand, but maybe we're moving toward that. Okay, and then the fundamental object, the multiset R, roofed subdivided polygons. And here's our fundamental identity for these things on a geometrical level involving these K-ary products. And then we connect all of this with algebra through a generating series or indicator series. Okay, and then we have some properties of this mapping from polygons to monomials. And then here's the fundamental identity for our generating series, which is a consequence of the fundamental identity for the roofed subdivided polygons. Okay, and then here's the formula for the RSP numbers. And here's the main claim that these things actually count, these numbers are natural numbers because they count the number of RSPs with a certain number of trigons, fourgons, fivegons, etc. And we also make contact with Euler's relations, which were quite important for us. So these numbers that were appearing here have, for us, geometrical content. Okay, that's quite important. So actually allows us to rewrite these things much more concisely if we're willing to talk about the vertices and the edges also. Okay, and the proof ultimately comes down to the counting result of the combinatorialists, Brendan Rhodes and possibly other people. Okay, so that's a key point. And then we have the formulation of the mega solution of the general geometric polynomial equation. There it is there, that form with remarkably kind of concise formula by the time, you know, you've encoded all this rich combinatorics into these coefficients R of M. And also, by the way, I am going to make an effort to adopt Mathematica type notation for functions. Since this is a novel paper, I get to introduce new thinking. Okay, so I think this is a very nice new thinking. Maybe not that new, but I think Mathematica and Wolfram, they are on the right track here by thinking of functions in square brackets to distinguish them from the brackets that we're using everywhere else. You know, there's too many brackets, so all of these things should be, whenever we have a function, we're going to end up putting them in square brackets at some point. Okay, and then the mega solution of the general polynomial equation, well, that's something like that, where we make that change of variable and we end up with an expression involving the general coefficients c0, c1, c2, c3, etc., crucially with a minus sign in front of the c1, which is crucially important. And then there's some room for further sections. Okay, so what does it look like? By the way, I should maybe say, where does the title, etc., come up? If I go right to the top here, so I'm creating a LaTeX document with Scientific Workplace, and if I look under typeset front matter, this is where you see the actual title and the author and the abstract. Okay, so it's not actually visible right now. But if I render this thing or typeset it, okay, typeset it, then here is what it looks like once it's, we've allowed LaTeX to do its great job. So title may be roofed subdivided polygons, the Fuss Catalan framework, and algebraic solutions to general polynomial equations. Something in that direction. We will no doubt change it as we go. And this is draft number one. So I'm going to make this thing available to you so you can kind of chart my progress. Okay? And you can get a sense of how one actually does this, or at least how I suggest that you do it. Okay? So we want a skeleton framework that has the rough structure of the thing so that we roughly know what the logical structure is, and then we're going to fill things in and explain things, okay? But it's nice to have that large scale structure reasonably clearly laid out in our minds. And what does this thing look like? There's a diagram, okay? Of course they will maybe be a bit nicer ultimately, but okay, that's nice to have some diagrams. I think more tables and more diagrams. Very important, I think. Okay, what's the next page look like? Oh, there's another diagram. This is showing us how to do one of these four array operations. Okay, we've got some solutions. This is all just the introduction. And here's that first section on the quadratic case. It's not very coherent in the cubic case, but you see the main formulas are there. Submultinomial coefficients, so definitions are there. We've got some arrays. Another array of bi-tri-quad numbers. Then we have our multiset connection with algebra, the RSP generating series, counting RSP numbers, and then the meta formula or mega. I'm calling it meta here and mega there. Okay, I'll have to decide which. So there's the geometric form, and then here is the general form, and then we have some other stuff. And these are not relevant. So I've gotten this by basically just taking an existing paper and using that framework because that has the dimensions and such laid out that's convenient for me. So I will eventually, of course, replace these with better references. Okay, so that's great. So that's kind of a start. So that's going to be draft one. And now I'm going to just go over it and spend some hours trying to improve it, putting things in the right spot, making it a little bit more reasonable and organized, okay? And we're slowly and steadily going to build this into a nice paper. And right now it's probably too early for you to give me feedback because it's just in a very preliminary stage. But in a few iterations, I will be asking you to give me some feedback, okay? So I think that will be very valuable, and maybe some suggestions and other ideas. Okay, so it's exciting. It's a different aspect, very important to be able to render mathematics ideas into actual paper that people may want to read.